Hello, good morning everyone. Welcome to our GKRB online classes. So today we are going to be discuss about the third chapter of our history textbook, and the chapter name is what? British administrative structure in India. Okay, in our previous classes we had discussed about how did the Britishers were able to conquest over the major regions of India like Bengal, Madras, and they were set up their business there, and also they were trying to make the government in that particular places. Okay, after that the Britishers conquest over Bengal. Okay, after that they were established their supremacy over Bengal. What? Trading supremacy as well as what? Political supremacy also they were what started from Bengal. Okay, after that later on the Britishers what rapidly grow up in administrative field. Okay, they were rapidly what expand their business, expand their trading. Okay, after you can say market also, after that they were also what follow the idea of imperialism and also tried to what settle or establish a colony in India. Okay, so the day is going on, the year going on. After that, the Britishers were able to occupy the major regions of India. Okay, in this chapter, we will discuss about what was the structure of administration of the Britishers. Means how they were able to control over a what over a territory over a what land of India. Means how did means what was the condition of their what. The Governor General, after that what was the condition of their civil services examinations. Okay, and what was the condition or how did they were able to regulate their army. Okay, and what is the condition of judicial system of that time. So in this chapter we are going to be discuss about all that matters. Okay, which was what performed by which was you can say acted by the British government. Got it? So let's move to the first topic, and that is what British expansion from 1798 to what 1809 under Lord Wellesley. After the Britishers were annexed what Bengal. Okay, they set up their political supremacy over there, and they had the what gained ideology of imperialism. Means they were wanted to conquest other major regions of what India. That's why Lord Wellesley what set up the Governor General of Bengal when in 1798. Okay, he was also took part in French Revolution towards the Britishers. The British he worked in the British army during French Revolution, which was happened in 1789 in France. Lord Wellesley also took part in repression of French Revolution. So the British government what appointed Lord Wellesley as the Governor General of Bengal. Okay, after that Lord Wellesley followed, or you can say introduced, the system of subsidiary alliance. What? The system of subsidiary alliance. Okay, according to subsidiary alliance, the Indian rulers had to what had to set up a military from Britishers in his court. Okay, means the Indian rulers had to keep or you can say kept a military for their protection. Means the Britishers provide the protection to the Indian rulers through the military power. Okay, after that the ruler or you can say the king had to what give permission to the Britishers for free trading in their territory. Okay, so Britishers were what able to gain also free trade facility in that matter, in that field, or you can say in that territory, in that place. After that the man military, or the you can say the expand of military. Okay, the money which was what expand in military department, it was also paid by the Indian rulers. Okay, so the rulers were the British military. Okay, they were capped by what? Indian rulers and British military. What gave protection to Indian rulers from their outsider rivals? Okay, and also the Indian rulers kept a British official in his court. Okay, so through this subsidiary alliance, Britishers were able to what? Occupy the court of the king also, occupy the market places or trading business, monopoly they were ruled over there. Okay, after that, the British or the expand of military of the Britishers, it was also saved by the Britishers. Got it? So many countries, many regions, or you can say many areas of the India or the Indian rulers, they were signed the subsidiary alliance system. Okay, some of the major what reasons of that time they were signed the subsidiary treaty. Nizam of Hyderabad, who was signed the treaty in 1798 from the beginning part. After that, Nawabs of Aut and Carnatic, they were also what obey the subsidiary alliance system. After that, what Peshwa Bajirao, okay, who had signed the treaty in 1802 century. Okay, after that, Sidhia and Bhosle and Holkar, these are the major rulers who were signed the subsidiary alliance system, which was introduced by what? Lord Wellesley, the Governor General of India. Got it? So the Britishers pursued the policies of annexation of Indian territory through what? Subsidiary treaty, or you can say subsidiary alliance system. After that, it was necessary for the Britishers to occupy the Marathas area, which were divided into four parts. Means five Indian rulers were ruled over their major territories. Okay, after the third war of Panipat, okay, the major territories were what ruled by Peshwa Bajirao. The Pune was ruled by Peshwa Bajirao. Okay, after that, Baroda, the Gaikwad dynasty were ruled there. After that, Nagpur was under of Bhosle ruler. Then Gwalior were occupied by Sindhias. Of the Sindhias were ruled over there, and the Indore got under Holkar. So this five major rulers were what occupied or ruled over five major territories of Maratha. Okay, these areas were known as the Maratha powers. Okay, so it was necessary for the Britishers to what? Annex the Maratha power also for their what? For their supremacy over India. Okay, that's why a gambling was what played by the Britishers, and a civil war was arose between the Maratha powers. Okay, means the Peshwa, Gaikwad, Holkar, Sindhias, Bhosle, these are involved in a civil war between them, and a Maratha war, a great Maratha war was what created in 18th century. Okay, a civil war had broke out between the Marathas, between Peshwa, Gaikwad, Bhosle, Holkar and Sindhias. Okay, after that, succession after the death of British Bajirao, Raghunath Rao or Raghoba invited the Britishers to help him against his rival. After means the ruler of Pune, Peshwa Bajirao, was dead, his throne ascended by Raghunath Rao, or Raghoba invited the Britishers as his friends because he was also signed the subsidiary alliance. Okay, help against his rival, or you can say enemy. Got it? After that, Madhav Rao II, the 7 year long first Maratha war came to end with the Treaty of Salbari, which was happened in 1782. The British could not make any immediate means after the first Maratha war happened or end, Britishers could not do any effort against the other Maratha power. Okay, means they just waited for the right, you can say, opportunity. Got it? After that, but the treaty gave them peace with Marathas. The peace proved beneficial for the British in their struggle against Mysore. So the what Salbai treaty, they were also who? The Britishers were also what you can say able to establish their supremacy over Mysore, because from the beginning, far beginning, the Britishers were what tried to what control over Mysore, because Mysore was the what major market place. But after the first Maratha war, the Britishers you can say Britishers signed a treaty named Treaty of Salbai in the year of 1782. After that, the Britishers were make what peace against the maintain peace against the Maratha powers, and after the Treaty of Salbai, the Britishers were able to also what conquest over Mysore. Okay, after that, the second Anglo-Maratha war broke out when the Marathas were fighting amongst themselves. Means the Maratha powers were what fight between them. Got it? Because a civil war broke out, so the Britishers were took the opportunity of this what civil war between the Marathas and the second Anglo-Maratha war was broke out. Okay, by then the British had won the Mysore wars. Peshwa Bajirao II sought British help against his brethren and signed the Satyagraha Treaty in 1802. Okay, later the British defeated the combined force of Sindhia and Bhosle. Means the Sindhia and Bhosle was also defeated by the Britishers in 1803. The Marathas surrendered territories and acknowledged the British as their what overlords. The war inflicted a severe blow to the power and prestige of the Marathas. Means after the second Anglo-Maratha war, the Britishers were able to what took over the Maratha powers under them, and they were what they were able to, or they were you can say succeed over what Maratha powers finally in 1803. They were occupied what all over Maratha powers. Got it? So the Britishers were what succeed or what expand their territory over Maratha areas. Means in the beginning, the Bengal Madras were what took over by the British. After that, what the Maratha powers were also gained by the Britishers, and the Britishers were succeed what over that regions, over that areas. Okay, after that expansion under Lord we can say Hastings or Warren Hastings. Okay, the Maratha powers, okay, in the period of Lord Wellesley, where the Governor General of Bangalore, okay, under his expansion, the Britishers were able to capture what Maratha powers. After what Lord Wellesley, what the Lord Hastings or Warren Hastings ascended the throne of Governor General of India, and under him, the Britishers were also able to occupy some regions of India. Okay, the third Maratha war was broke out between the Peshwa, Bhosle and Holkar on one side and the British on the other. Mean the Holkar, Bhosle and Peshwa, okay, they what you can say combined a alliance against the Britishers, and the third Anglo-Maratha war was happened between Holkar, Bhosle, Peshwa and other side the British military. Okay, in this last war, the British defeated the Marathas decisively. Means the Maratha powers, means the Bhosle, Peshwa and Holkar, they were also received what defeated from the Britishers. Okay, after that they exiled Peshwa to Bithur. Means the Peshwa was exiled by the British power to Bithur, which was placed near what Kanpur. Then and installed a descendant of Shivaji on the throne of Satara. A small state, Holkar also accepted the subsidiary alliance. The Maratha power had finally what scumbled or finally came to under the what Britishers. Means the expansion under Lord Warren Hastings, which was what happened in 1830 to 23, means finally under the leadership of Warren Hastings, the Maratha powers were came into what and came in the under of the British power under the leadership of Lord Hastings. Okay, after that the Sindh territory or Sindh region was annexed by the Britishers in the year of 1843, and Punjab also occupied by the Britishers in 1846. Okay, through a treaty, and that treaty named what? Treaty of Lahore. Punjab was also annexed by the Britishers in 1846. Okay, so many important regions now came under the Britishers, and they were able to do what? They were also succeeded over that areas, and what they established their market colonies over there, and rapidly they were what tried to make a supremacy over that region. Okay, after that, under the Dalhousie, Lord Dalhousie was Governor General of India, and he was also took some important policies he was also implemented or executed for the expansion of India or for the annexation of major territories of India. Okay, Lord Dalhousie was introduced doctrine of lapse policy. He executed the policy and doctrine of lapse for the annexation, for the conquest over other remaining major regions of India, major places of India. So what was the doctrine of lapse policy which was introduced by what? Lord Dalhousie. What? Dalhousie wanted to bring what? Subordinate states under direct British rule. Indian rulers had what outlived their utility for the British. He wanted to do away with them. Then Dalhousie annexed what? Satara, Jhansi, Nagpur, etc. by applying the policy of doctrine of lapse. So this means denial of the right to adopt a child. Means if the emperor, if the king didn't have any child, he could not accept or he could not adopt what? Child. Got it? After that, if the ruler died without a natural heir, without a what, son, without a what you can say, without a son, without a child, okay, his state would be annexed by the Britishers. Okay, after that, the rulers could not adopt a child only with the approval of the Britishers. Got it? Means the Indian rulers, according to the doctrine of lapse policy, if the Indian rulers didn't have any child, okay, they could not what adopted any child from the what you can say outside. Okay, if he had what the real child, then the child after the ruler, the child will be the ruler of that region. Okay, but what the ruler or the Indian king could not what adopted any child from the outside. If he wish what to adopt a child, that he should what take the permission of the Britishers. Okay, so by the doctrine of lapse, Lord Dalhousie what occupied or annexed many major territories, because many Indian rulers didn't have what the real child. So many major territories of India was annexed by the Britishers under the leadership of Lord Dalhousie, who was introduced for doctrine of lapse policy against the Indian rulers. Okay, after that, the Britishers were occupied or conquered over the major territories of India. Okay, and they were started to establish a government over that area. So British Parliament and East India Company mean the Britishers came to India or reached to India with the purposes of only trading business. Okay, but after that they were war against other rivalries of what their trading unit means like the French, Dutch. After that, the Portuguese, okay, they were got defeated by the Britishers, and Britishers were established a what trading monopoly over India. After that, they were what started to annexation, you can say process in India. They were controlled over what major means important places, important regions of India, and they were started a business in India as well as they were started to rule over India. That's why they were also what Britishers, they were started a parliament in India. Okay, the East India Company basically what remained a trading company from 1600 to 1757, means before they were what annexed Bengal. After the Bengal annexation, the Britishers were set up a government in India. Okay, from the beginning of annexation process from Bengal. Okay, after that it continued to drive its rights from Royal Charter 31st December 1600. Okay, then the Britishers were played new role in Indian administrative system. They were started a government, established a government in India after 1757. After its victory over what Bengal and the grant of Diwani, the company, while remaining a trading organization, also became a political power in India after the Bengal what annexation. And they also what availed the facility of Diwani, means they were collected the revenue of that area, or they were also what maintained free trade facilities over Bengal. Okay, then the East India Company established dual government system in Bengal. This system continued for 7 years only. The dual government system was continued in Bengal for 7 years. During the period, the company what continued to give priority to its commercial interest. That MSD was remained the prime concern of the company and its officer. Means during dual government system, the company only what gave his eyes on what the drain of Indian wealth through the trading business. Okay, and they were also what you can say arise as a political power in India. Got it? Then the Britishers set up a parliament over what Bengal and other major territories, and what parliament and the company. After that, the parliament was formed by the Britishers, and also the company was what continued or maintained by the Britishers. Got it? After the annexation, or you can say conquest over what many important territories of India, the Britishers were what established a government also there. Okay, after that the changing in position with the parliament, you can say the British government and the company, they were what maintained cooperation with them, and what parliament and company what changed its position day by day. Okay, through a regulating act which was passed in 1773, what the regulating act, the British government what expand, or you can say expand the territory. Okay, and also controlled over the company, who the British government, the number of what directors who were what direct the administrative policy, administrative system over a region, the number of directors were also increased. Okay, it brought the affairs what relating to revenue and military directly under the British government. Mean the British government wrote the regulating act, okay, of 1773. The directors what related, or directors were what involved in affairs relating to what revenue and military directly under the British गवर्नमेंट. ओके, इट डेजिग्नेटेड द गवर्नर ऑफ बंगाल एज गवर्नर जनरल. गुड. व्हाट द रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट 1773 व्हाट डेजिग्नेटेड द गवर्नर जनरल ऑफ बंगाल एज द गवर्नर जनरल ऑफ होल इंडिया. ओके, ही वॉज टू फंक्शन विद द असिस्टेंस ऑफ ए फोर मेंबर्स काउंसिल्स. मीन्स द गवर्नर जनरल हेल्प बाय द फोर मेंबर्स और यू कैन से काउंसिल वॉज हेल्प द गवर्नर जनरल टू मेंटेन व्हाट द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव पॉलिसी ओवर इंडिया. गॉट इट. आफ्टर दैट डिसीजंस वर टू बी टेकन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द मेजोरिटी ऑफ वोट्स. मीन्स मेनी डिसीजंस वर टेकन व्हाट विद द हेल्प ऑफ मेजोरिटी वोट्स. मीन्स द काउंसिल और यू कैन से द काउंसिलर्स वर गिव द मेजोरिटी टू द गवर्नर जनरल. आफ्टर द गवर्नर जनरल विल टेक द डिसीजन. गॉट इट. आफ्टर दैट इट्स ऑरिजिनल कैरेक्टर वॉज ऑल्सो रिटन. द एक्ट रेकॉग्नाइज इट्स वॉट स्टेटस एज अ पॉलिटिकल पावर. मीन इट शोज द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट वॉट इज सुप्रीम गवर्नमेंट. आफ्टर दैट इट्स ऑरिजिनल कैरेक्टर वॉज ऑल्सो रिटन. गॉट इट. आफ्टर दैट द पीस इंडिया एक्ट विच वॉज इम्प्लीमेंटेड और पास इन 1784 रिमूव द डिमेरिट्स ऑफ रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट. ओके, मीन द पीस ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट पास इन 1784 एंड वाई इट वॉज पास. वाई डिड इट वॉज पास फॉर द वर्ड फॉर डिसमिस द यू कैन से द माइनस पॉइंट ऑफ द रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट. ओके, द डिमेरिट्स ऑफ रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट. So the new act established the control of the British government over the company through the what? Peace India Act 1784. The British government was what? Took the charge of or took the responsibility of the company. Got it? Then, but still all the trading activities, okay, remained exclusively under the company. Means, however, the British government was able to what give supremacy or maintain supremacy over the you can say trading business of the East India Company. All the what trading activities, okay, trading you can say performance were controlled by the company. Got it? Means free trade was introduced and due to this company trade monopoly was broken. The act also reduces the strength of the Governor General Council from 4 to 3. Another act, Charter Act of 1783. The Charter Act was also passed what empowered the Governor General to designate the majority under special circumstances. The act thus placed the presidencies of Bombay and Madras under Governor General and the Council of Bengal. Means through the Charter Act which was passed in 1793, the Governor General was able to gain his prestige. Okay, and he also made the presidencies, the major presidencies, Bengal, Madras, that Bombay were under the what Governor General of India. Means through the Charter Act of 1793, the Governor General what retained his prestige over political supremacy over administration. Got it? After that, the Britishers means the company and parliament through the according to this act, the Regulating Act of 1773, the Peace Act and Peace India Act of 1784, the Charter Act of 1793, the Parliament in the government and the company, they were what changed its position over the administrative system. Okay. After that, the many agencies were also created or formed by the Britishers for rule over India or for show off their supremacy over India. So, what were the agencies? like the civil services, after that the police, then the jurisdiction, you can say the judicial system was also what combined by the Britishers, then the army, then the police. So this agency were created by the Britishers for a what? Good or for a, you can say for a smooth administrative work. Okay. Okay. For the better administration, the Britishers were created or formed many agencies for rule over India. Okay. So the agencies like civil services, then they formed also the army, the police, then the judicial system. These are the important agencies, or you can say organ, or you can say also department of what the Britishers for their better administration over India. Okay. So first word, civil services. What was civil services, or nowadays what is civil services? So Lord Cornwallis was the what Governor General of India during his period. Okay. Who founded, or you can say introduced, the civil services in India. Got it? The civil servant were for all practical purposes the rulers of India. Means if the person will able to clear the civil services in India, after that he will be appointed as the Governor General of India. So mostly the Europeans, or you can say the Englishers, were took you can say gain the permission to face civil services in India. The Indians were didn't face what civil services examinations. Got it? Then the civil servant paid very what handsome salary, or you can say very high salary. The prestigious job and high salaries attracted the young men of British family to face what civil to attempt civil services examination. Then initially only British families were given jobs civil servants. Indians were not allowed to enter civil service. Okay. In fact, in 1793, a rule was made that no Indian would be eligible for past above $500. Okay. Then Lord Wellesley introduced a training program for the company's civil services. He founded Fort William College at Kolkata in the 18th century. Then for this purpose, the company established its own training college at Haileybury in England, 1806th century, in the name of East India College. So the Englishmen, the Britishers only allowed it to what face civil services examinations. Okay, the Indians were not allowed by the Britishers. Got it? After that, the main purpose of serving the company was to become rich and get what promotions on the basis of seniority, corruption, what spite. So the Britishers were what created what civil services examination. Who Lord Cornwallis introduced the system of civil services examination. By this civil services examination, the Britishers were able to what make the post of what Governor General of India. Okay, who the Indians were not allowed to what face what civil services examination. Okay. After that, what was the condition of army? Okay, and means during the British period, armies or military was created by the Britishers. Or how did they were the Britishers were regulated the army? So during the process of conquest, means annexation. Okay, the army was the most important force of the East India Company. It remained the second most important pillar of administration. Means by the armed force, armed power, the Britishers were what captured the vast country like India, and it was possible through the what military force, or you can say the army. Okay, it was instrumental in the company's growth, expansion, and protection of its trade. It played a decisive role in conquering the Indian state for the company. Okay, so mainly in army divisions, okay, many Indian soldiers were there, but the high posts were what you can say captured by the Britishers only. Okay, the highest position that an Indian could hold in the army was that of a subedar. Okay, the highest position was kept by an Indian soldier, but in high rank, in high positions only there were the Britisher who captured the high position. Got it? But many Indian soldiers were in the army, army department or Britishers, because they need a vast, or you can say huge army, or you can say the huge soldiers, number of soldiers. That's why they were appointed the Indian soldier into the army groups. Got it? After that, the police. What was the police department? Okay, or you can say how did the police department was work in that period? So Lord Cornwallis was established a regular police department to maintain law, order, and peace. Under the system, the district superintendent of police, or you can say SP, was the head of the police in a district. So who was the head of a district in the field of police department? SP or district superintendent of police was the head of police department in a district. Okay, the district was divided into number of thanas. Each thana was under a daroga. The daroga had armed men under him to maintain peace and order. Okay, towns had a kotwal. The villages had watchmen or chowkidar who served as informers. So the Britishers were also what administered police department in district area. Okay, the SP was the head of a district. After that, the districts were divided into many thanas, and daroga was the in charge of the thanas. And also they were placed the chowkidars in every villages. Got it? Then the judicial system, which was what you can say maintained by the Britishers. What was the condition of judicial system during British power? So the British retained the traditional system during the early years of their rule. Warren Hastings was the first governor general who paid attention towards the organization of the system of justice. Who? Warren Hastings. A Supreme Court was established in India for the first time at Kolkata in 1774 by what? Warren Hastings. A Supreme Court was formed in Kolkata in 1774. The British judicial system was applied to all Indians in the territories under British control. Okay, means the Britishers always follow the rule of law, make a policy named rule of law. The Britishers were follow that rule of law. Okay, so what was the rule of law? Means every people of a country, through the rule of the Britishers in judicial system, every people are equal before law. Okay, this was what the rule of law. But the British government always was favored to the Europeans. Means there was no, you can say, no law according to the Britishers, or in the you can say the form of equality, there was no law for the Indians. Okay, means all the British government follow the rule of law, hence they were what always favored to the what European people. The white people were, you can say, favored by the Britishers. Means there was no equality between white people and the Indians. Got it? So under the new judicial system, justice was very expensive and beyond the reach of the common man. It was time consuming too. Then prevalence of corruption made matters even worse. The introduction of the system made the role of the panchayat system less important. The British raised an administrative structure and increased their grip over India. Their aim was to make India a subordinate partner of Britain. India was to be a market for British goods and a supplier of raw material. Okay, mean in the beginning they were what gave eye on India as a what market, but later on they were what succeed all over India and annex the major territories of India, and they were able to what happened there to supreme throne of India. Okay, so the agencies, so civil services, so army, so police department, so judicial system, the Britishers were what conquered all over India, and they were ruled over India over a long period of 200 years. Got it? Then other reforms is other changes were brought by many governor general of India in during British period, like what economy reforms of Lord Cornwallis was brought up. Okay, then reforms of dead houses in the field of railway construction. Okay, reforms means many changes were occurred by what many governor general, many what you can say, many reformer of India, governor general, mostly the English reformer, and what Lord Cornwallis, what Lord Cornwallis introduced the system of Jamindari as well as permanent settlement. Through the Jamindari system, the Jamindars were what got the permission or got the rights towards conquest over a territory, small territory, and they were the responsible person to collect the what revenue from the farmers, from the peasants, and pay to the British government. After that, the permanent settlement was introduced by what Lord Cornwallis. So in the field of agriculture, in the field of revenue, what many reforms, many changes were occurred by Lord Cornwallis. After that, reforms by what Dalhousie, the Governor General of India, he also took many changes in the field of railway construction. Okay, he decided the future policy of railway in India. He proposed a network of 4 main trunk lines. He established modern postal system and introduced the telegraph system in India. Please note it. The most important thing that Lord Dalhousie what introduced the telegraph system in India, and also the postgraph system in India. Got it? Postal system in India. After that, the first telegraph line from Calcutta to Agra was opened in 1853. The first telegraph line from Calcutta to Agra was opened in 1805-53. Main cities of Calcutta, Peshawar, Bombay and Madras were telegraphically connected to each other. Means with the efforts of Lord Dalhousie. Okay, then Lord Dalhousie also introduced the what stamp system in postal department. So many changes like Jamindari system, then permanent settlement, after that the railway construction, the postal system, after that the postage stamp system in postal department. So many changes were what occurred in Indian society, in Indian administrative system by the Governor General of India like Lord Cornwallis and Lord Dalhousie. So this is all about the chapter number 3, what British administrative structure in India. They were able to what rule over India for a long period of 200 years through the agency like civil services, the army, the police and the judicial system. I hope you all got the topics, or you all are clearly understood the points coming from the British administrative structure in India. Thank you. Have a nice day.